Biff Romulus here, just tractoring and motoring up some of the very famous rough road on the Cheam Trail. Plan is to head up to Mount Cheam and try out some of the new gear and see how it's working. So stay tuned, we'll keep in touch. Five minutes up the trail, and looks like we've got some decent visibility, at least up to about 6,000 feet. And I'm just happy that it's not raining right now. It's actually pretty nice.
Across the road from hope, I'm under the bridge in riptides, taking everything I call my own. One step closer to knowing, one step closer to knowing. I can't go forward now, can't turn back, can't see the future, it's getting away from me. I just watch the daylights glowing, one step closer to knowing, one step closer to knowing.
You see? This is what happens. You pay your money and you take your chance. 45 minutes ago I was up. I can see where I was now. Still quite a ways from the top, but a little higher than I am right now. And thick pea soup, ice on the rocks. And now here you go. 45 minutes later, it's pretty well open right to the top. Now what are you gonna do? I ask you, what are you gonna do? I'll tell you what you're gonna do. You're gonna finish off this climb and you're gonna set your house up and you're gonna party. You're gonna party like it's 2009. The view is to die for, literally.
Well, good evening. It's about 7:15 on the summit of Mount Cheam, and apart from the fact that my stove didn't work, I'm very comfortable. I'm here in my little mountain hardware, one man sort of half tent, half bivvy, and my sleeping bag is warm as toast, and my toes are hurting a bit, which means the feeling's coming back into them. The boots didn't quite cut it today. And I'm settling in. It's just have to kind of get into it now and enjoy my book. Anyway, up on the top of Mount Cheam for the very first time doing an overnighter. This is Biff Romulus saying goodnight.
Well, good morning, Fraser Valley. Here it is, 7:15. 12 hours in the sack, 12 hours in the tent. Wind picked up at about 3 in the morning. Brief concerns about being blown off into the abyss, but they didn't last very long. And I've been woken up to a glow that you can see behind my head. And I'm now going to show you what I see. Pretty impressive. Sun is rising. On my little palace. Welcome to the Quality Inn.
I had an apology from Brad Henry this morning that he couldn't be up with me. He was sorry that I had to sleep alone, and for the whole night I definitely thought I was sleeping alone. As I made my way down from the tent this morning, I took a slightly different trail and immediately came upon huge bear prints. So, thanks Brad, but I wasn't alone.
You know what I'm really looking forward to? A Tim Hortons double-double. Bye.